Hi, in this video, we'll be discussing about local volumes, and we'll see how we can create a storage class, PV, PVC, and use that inside a pod. Now, let's see the storage class. Now, in this particular scenario, the storage class is named as local storage, and the provisioner is no provisioner. The local volumes do not support dynamic provisioning, so the PV and the PVC has to be created manually. And the volume binding mode is wait for the first consumer. Now this delays the binding of a PVC to a PV, which helps the scheduler to schedule the pod in the right way and follow all the constraints. So this is the storage class. So let's first create the storage class. Kubectl create hyphen fsc. Kubectl get sc. So the storage class is created. Now let's see what do we have in PV. So this is a simple persistent volume, and in the spec section we have defined the storage class name as local storage, which we just created, the capacity, access mode, read write once, and the host path. So this will be on the host path opt/data/opt/data, and let's create the persistent volume. Kubectl create hyphen fpv, and let's now see what do we have in PVC. So in PVC, it's a simple persistent volume claim, Kubernetes object, and storage class name is local storage, access mode, read write once, same as the PV, and then the resource request is less than the capacity of the PV. So we are good over here. So let's create it. Kubectl create hyphen fpvc. So we have kubectl get PV, PVC. So PV and PVC is there, but the status is pending. Now this is because unless and until we create a pod, the status will remain in pending. So now let's look at the pod configurations. So the pod is also a simple pod where in the volume section, we have defined a persistent volume claim and the claim name that we just created. And a simple Nginx container with port, and it's mounted as user share Nginx HTML folder inside the pod. So let's create that. Kubectl create hyphen f pod. And now let's look at the PV PVC. And we can see the status immediately has turned to bound. And kubectl get pods hyphen y just to see where it is running. So it is running on node 3. And let's create a file, kubectl exec hyphen it. So let's create a file in Nginx HTML. So cd echo hello. And index.html. Now, if we do curl localhost, so we are getting hello. And this particular thing is running on node 3. So I already have node 3 opened. And let's go to cd/opt and data. So we can see index.html has come over here. So this is how the persistent volume and the PVC is created when we have to use the local storage, and the bounding happens when the pod is created. So if I do exit and if I kubectl delete, get pods and delete the pod, kubectl delete pod, hyphen hyphen force, hyphen hyphen grace, period zero. Now, though we have deleted the pod, the PV and the PVC will still stay because the persistent volume claim are the volumes that is separate from the pod lifecycle. So the persistent volume object and the persistent volume claim object are separate Kubernetes resources that are managed by Kubernetes, and it is separate from the pod lifecycle. So if we see kubectl get PV and PVC, we can see both are still there and it is already bounded. And since the reclaim policy is retained, so even if the PVC is deleted, the PV will still remain. So let's delete that, kubectl delete. So the PVC is deleted and we should still, kubectl get PV, we should still have the PV with the released status. So this is how the volumes, local volumes work in Kubernetes, and you can create the storage class, local storage class, and use that, manually create the PV, PVC, and the PV and the PVC won't bound unless and until the pod is created. That's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.